We are now in the final round, so the finals of What's on the Moon, which is level 3 of phase 2. We're one of 4 teams that have gone to the final round now, and we're very excited and working very hard to finish things up in time.
Artemis is NASA's mission to go to the moon, right? To create a sustainable presence on the moon. We've been to the moon before, obviously, but we want to go there this time to stay. Our part in Artemis is to help establish that infrastructure system where we can transmit power from outside of a crater to inside of a crater because everything needs electrical power.
We're making hardware and we're doing testing on our own, and we'll be going to NASA facilities and testing that hardware, and they'll be directly inspecting that test.
The final test is taking place in NASA Glenn's vacuum chamber. But one of the key items of our whole technology idea was the use of superconducting tethers. However, in the vacuum chamber at NASA Glenn, we will not be able to achieve that low superconducting critical temperature. And that means that our original concept is not going to work in the vacuum chamber. It will work fine on the moon, it just will not work during the final test. And that means that we have to redesign various pieces of the solution so that it would work essentially with a completely different tether than we had originally designed. But that's part of this journey. And, you know, there's an important mental component to that, right? You have to take a deep breath, reground yourself, and then say, can we do this, yes or no? And then take stock of everything that needs to happen and say, you know what, yes, we can do this.
The point of the competition wasn't to make something that can go into space, though eventually maybe a successor to this would go into space. It's to be an energy storage and delivery and make sure it works in this vacuum chamber. And that's pretty much it.
Past the What's on the Moon challenge, we actually want to send this to the moon at some point. So it's kind of hard for us not to design those things, you know, as part of the project and kind of just focus on the mass optimization. That's important, very important for the moon. You want to like reduce mass, but you know, we want to put others like small design changes and they're just like, aren't really like mass optimum, but are kind of like necessary for space.
That's actually our goal in our lab here is to get an actual piece of hardware on a lunar mission to lunar surface. So that's one of the goals, the very important one.
It is pretty high stress, but the team is very relaxed. And so I think in general, the key is not to let it get to you.
We just do cookouts and stuff, go hiking, camping and stuff together. So
a big part of the success of the team is that like, I would consider everybody in the lab a friend.
So we became friends like through the lab for the most part, just kind of working here. And our advisor, Paul, makes a really good environment for us to work in and to succeed. He handles a lot of like the overhead stuff and a lot of issues. He takes a lot of the politics away from us and kind of like lets us focus on just the technical side of things and getting our stuff done and focusing on like the missions.
The team has been, you know, magnificent in figuring out what needs to be done and do the small things that contribute to the whole and then bringing it all together and making it work. It's a product, a solution that they strongly believe in. I think we have a great concept. But making that happen, of course, is really something to be very proud of. Just to make it happen, to build it, to test it, to see that it works. It is, I think, one of the coolest experiences as an engineer to have an idea and then get to build it and test it and see that it works. And that is a challenge that with a complex problem like this is very difficult to do. But the team has really done a great job at all of those steps.